Here is Chris Gardner ready for the kickoff, and this game is underway. It's coming over to the side to Irving Spikes, number 22. And Spikes takes it and fumbles the ball. It is fallen on by Mississippi State. Gary Hollingsworth is the quarterback. He has thrown 11 interceptions this year and only 4 touchdown passes, and was replaced in the game last week against Penn State by Danny Woodson. We understand we could even see Scott Etter in this game today for Alabama. So Hollingsworth, last year heralded hero, this year under fire with the lack of production offensively. And they run it up the middle and there's some production. A first down from the true freshman, Chris Anderson, only 5'7", 175 from Huntsville, a gain of 12 yards to open this ball game. First down, out at about the 33-yard line. Hollingsworth to throw on the run. He's got a man wide open. It is complete to Steve Buskey, the tight end, to the 49-yard line. Alabama has not been successful in this conversion situation. As you see, only 17% this year. They'll hand it, play fake it, hand it to Kevin Turner. Well done, play fake, I might say, as Turner kept the ball, gets the first down. Reggie Stewart tripped him up. Keep our eyes open to see what happened to Kevin Turner, the starting fullback. Here's Anderson around the right side. He has the good speed. He is knocked out of bounds at the 30-yard line by Eddie Miles, number 35, a gain of 10.
Well, to say they were ineffective last week is a euphemism. It was just an embarrassing performance last week, and they're going to be out to make up for that this week.
On the second down, they fake the reverse, and Anderson drops it. Here come the Bulldogs. Down goes Anderson, back here at the 30. See Stewart on the sidelines here for the third down play out of the shotgun. The shovel pass to Anderson. He's inside the 20 now. Inside the 15. First down, Alabama. Aldridge with the stop on the shovel pass. A gain of 16 yards. Third down one, Alabama. Tackle and gets the first down on second effort. He was hit at the 4. Second down goal. Turning in motion. Hand off Jones. That's right guard. Touchdown, Alabama. Galloway hit in the backfield. Oh, my. The penetration first by 94, George Thornton. This is Mike Riley, junior from Arkansas. Oh, my. Jared Young is the man with the ball, and Alabama gets another big break early in this ball game.
I think that the ball got stuck. It just didn't get it out of the dirt. It got caught in a divot. Jared Young didn't want it. You know, I mean, he certainly wasn't expecting it. Everybody was downfield, so that was just unfortunate incident for the snapper. They'll try to run some type of influence, some type of play pass.
Russell will left, and now Turner flaring over the block. They're looking into the end zone. Diving attempt at the grab by Chris Anderson.
Would have been a nice catch, but it certainly could have been a catch.
This will be a 25-yard field goal attempt by Philip Doyle. It's Blitzman, and Alabama now has a new all-time scoring leader. Third down, 3. Shell has a man there. It is complete for the first down to Chris Furl out at the 46-yard line of Alabama. McMillan covering. Third down, 15. See if Alabama comes on this or drops into cover. They're going to cover. Shell has time. Of the intended receiver, Tony James, by Brian Stutson, number 39, third down 8. Lamon Russell slipped as he made his cut out at the 45. The pass goes incomplete. Tank Williamson will punt to the nation's leading punt returner. Tony James averages 16 and a half yards per return. A couple of touchdowns already this year. Good job this time out to the 48-yard line. You see why he's the nation's leader. He gets it right up the middle in a hurry. Inside 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Alabama leading 10-0. Here's Kenny Roberts. He has running room. Inside Alabama territory to the 44-yard line.
Crimson Tide is terrific at stopping third down conversions, particularly third down and long. They hand it off to Jared Young for four. No conversion that time. John Sullins makes the tackle for Alabama. Fourth down, five. Mississippi State going for it early. In and out of the hands of Jerry Bolden. Another drop pass. It was rifled in there. Hollingsworth going deep, missing everybody. He was looking way downfield for Kevin Lee.
Mississippi State still trying to get something going. They've had some
personal
shots,
foul
but
on
they
the defense is a 15-yard penalty
hang on the ball.
First down.
Here comes Robert Jones to the 39. Ball came loose after he had hit the ground. From the 36, nice fake by Hollingsworth. Lamon Russell was well covered.
It's a face masking penalty on the offense. It's a 15-yard penalty. It'll be first down again.
Second down, 25. Hollingsworth under some pressure. He got rid of it. That is kind of an incomplete pass because he threw it right at the feet of Robert Jones. They fake the blitz. Tony James came away with it. Short of the first down. Houston is close to the first down on his second and third effort, but I don't think he got there. Williamson with a low line drive to Tony James at the 20. Not much blood. Ball's loose. Alabama ball at the 33-yard line. Third down, 12. Jones goes in motion. Hollingsworth finds Jones to the 28, maybe the 27. Short of the first down.
He's trying to salvage 3 points here.
Making a 45-yard field goal attempt by Doyle. What a kicker. This guy's the best field goal kicker in America. 45 yards.
35.
Roberts. First down. Out to the 36-yard line. Nice job of running the ball by Kenny Roberts. Shell gets it loose to Willie Harris. Penalty markers are down. Harris gets only about a yard or so, and that's all. Here's a good view of it. You'll see the opening if there is one. Good protection this time.
Anderson.
Anderson at the 25. Out to the 38. Penalty flags are down.
Flipping on the return. The penalty's half the distance to the goal line. It'll be first down.
Anderson. Big hole. All the way to the 32-yard line, and whether or not it was clipping is really insignificant at this point. Third down, about two. Kevin Turner's second effort is close. They hit him right at the line of scrimmage. Demetrius Hill did. Third down and five. Jones looking for the first down and getting it. Our game hasn't been selected yet, but that's one of the possibilities, Georgia, Florida. Anderson, the ball came loose, and Mississippi State has it. Kenny Roberts to the 43. Got the first down.
Here they come.
Shell gets rid of it, but it's flopping up and is intercepted by Stacy Harrison. It had been 99 passes since the interception. Now there's a penalty marker down. Fumbled snap. Hollingsworth falls out. They'll probably just let that clock run out here. And they're going to stop it with 4 seconds. Leading punt returner in the nation. Almost got it, too. I don't believe he called a fair catch. Explain that one when we come back. At halftime, the score, Alabama 13, Mississippi State nothing. No school has produced NFL quarterbacks who have accounted for more passing yards than the University of Alabama. These signal callers are the subject of today's Citgo History Feature. Shell screens it out successfully to Trenell Edwards for a gain of about 7 out near the 45-yard line. Philadelphia, Mississippi is home, the home of Marcus Dupree. Out near the 50-yard line goes 29 Kenny Roberts. Steve Webb with a tackle. 7 defensive backs in there this time, so they'll try to run it. Nothing happening. Roberts down at the 48. Derek Oden, the inside linebacker, and the Boo Birds come out.
Finally, Ryan Ford made the play.
Juan Russell goes in motion. Here comes Anderson over to the left side. Nice change of pace by Anderson, and he gets out to the 32. Aldridge makes the stop for the Bulldogs.
Some of the scouts think he's too slow, but I'd like to have a couple of too slow guys like that on my team.
Hollingsworth in some trouble, finding Kevin Turner as the outlet to the 46-yard line.
And then with all those injuries,
Hollingsworth has his man wide open. That's Kevin Lee, who gets to the 37-yard line of Mississippi State.
Games are won and lost on the line of scrimmage. By dominating the line of scrimmage, will you rush for 6 yards? You know who's dominating the line of scrimmage.
Hollingsworth with a play action. Screens to Anderson. Nice blocking. Anderson out of bounds at the 21-yard line. With good protection. It is complete to 83 Steve Buskey. Just got that play off before the shot clock went down. It's picked off in the end zone by Albert Williams. Williams just spun around and there it was. Second down 10. Edwards picked off by Alabama at the 27-yard line, and it was John Sullins who got the interception. That's his third of the year. TBS and TNT has NFL coming up tomorrow. Olympic gold, earning his money, though. Almost caught by Lamon Russell. He still does not have a catch in this ball game. Philip Doyle going for his third field goal of the ball game. He's got a 25 and a 45. This one's from 40. It's good. Philip Doyle leads the nation in field goals per game, averaging 2.3, has 3 in this game. Bolden has not caught a pass today. He's the leading receiver for Mississippi State. Now he finally gets one. And he stays in bounds out to the 33-yard line. Set up the middle with Kenny Roberts, a gain of about 10. 16-0, Alabama leading here. Third quarter, 4 minutes remaining. Mississippi State ball, third and short. Roberts gets the first down. Not much more, but it's enough. Here comes Alabama. That was Stewart again, just blowing right up the middle. Thornton was back there too. Third down, 20. We're going to get a penalty marker here against Mark McMillan. Here comes Alabama. Ephraim Thomas just ran right through Tony Shell.
No chance to let it go. He had no outlet there, no place to go with it. He did the only thing he could do.
Riley is hit as he punts it, and the flag goes down. It is America. You do have a right to a defense.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker on the defense is 15 yards on first down.
And here's Kenny Roberts for the opening. To the 30-yard line of Alabama, John Sullins made the stop, and this is the deepest penetration of the day for Mississippi State. Shell has time. Incomplete at the six. Fans here wanted a flag, none coming.
Seven defensive backs in there now for Alabama. Bob.
Shell has it. Three-man rush for Shell. Almost picked off right in the arms of John Sullins. Another one is blocked. Came off very low.
First producer.
First and 15 from the 28. Hollingsworth finds Donnie Finkley out here at the 39-yard line. And let's go back to Atlanta and Ernie Jr.
10-zip, Virginia over Tech. Back to you.
More, and more. On the second down, a long three. They give it inside to Turner out near the 45.
He's been nailed with injuries on the outside, and until he gets his kids ready to run on the outside, they need somebody that knows what they're doing.
On third down, four, Hollingsworth. Lofting it into double coverage. On the first down for the Bulldogs. Shell has four. Out across the 35. Odin with the stop for Alabama. Shell has a man open. It's Tony James. To the 35-yard line. Ephraim Thomas with the stop. Shell completes another one for the 27. They're saying it was taken out of his arms, Alabama ball. They took it right out of the arms of Tredis Anderson. On the second down, here comes Anderson. Another big opening. To the 43-yard line. Four wideouts in there for the Crimson Tide on the third down short yardage. They throw it to the running back, Kevin Turner, first down. Turner to the 15-yard line. Number 66, I'm going to tell him you said that. That was Tim Rudger. Here comes Robert Jones inside the five. He's kind of a bowling ball himself at 195-10.
The Bulldogs showing some real pride here on defense, making it tough for the Crimson Tide.
Jones finally goes airborne for the touchdown. Going for 2 points is Alabama. And failing, intended for Kevin Turner.
A lot of mobility there.
Old Brooks can be quick, but I don't think Nifty would fit Old Brooks. This time, Kenny Roberts with the handoff. He gets near the 40. On third down short yardage, here's Robinson getting the first down and a little more out to the 45. Auburn certainly in the driver's seat. Intended curl almost picked off when it went off of Furl's hands.
Alabama only 21 points in the last four games. It's about as good as it gets.
They just cave in on Robinson back at the 35, led by Robert Stewart. Here's Spikes. He's only about 5'10", 190-pounder also, though. And there's Scott Etter. Scott's a sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky. He played a little bit in the game last week against Penn State. And they're just going to let this clock run down, and this game's going to be all over. I don't think we'll see another play. And Alabama gets a defensive victory here today. The offense hadn't been bad, but 12 quarters without allowing a touchdown now. Four forced turnovers today, a blocked field goal, three quarterback sacks. I could go on and on. Mrs. Stallings happy for her husband, who had a very rough start in his first year at Alabama, going 0-3, but now getting them together over in Tuscaloosa, and they'll go home to play LSU next week with an even record of 4-4, a 22-0 win here in Starkville. We'll join Ernie Johnson with scores and highlights right after this.